Hey, how's it going? Dirt D back with you once again. Continuing our let's play with Stellaris with the Star Trek New Horizons mod, playing as the Cardassians. Apologize if this Cardassian episode's a little bit later than usual. Trying to get the let's plays kind of under control. I started the Star Wars mod as well and was looking through my video list and it's like, hey, I haven't actually played the Cardassians a while, so I thought I should get on that. So apologize if you've been waiting extra long for a Cardassians episode. I do enjoy playing them. It's got caught up in a few different things. So here we are. We are the Cardassians. And let's take a look at the galaxy here now. Of course, last time we did retake Bajor, I believe it was. Thought about invading the Ferengi, but that didn't happen because we had to wait for an arbitrary date. So I decided to make my way up to the Gamma Quadrant and declare a war on the, who is it? The Agartharians? Whatever their name is. We're up in the Gamma Quadrant, we're causing trouble, and we'll see what we can do. We'll see if we can actually make it go. But I'm not sure if it's going to work out for us, but hey, we'll do our best. And, you know, I was trying to figure out, you know, why why took our ship so long to get kind of up through this nebula? Well, there is an in-universe explanation for it. Of course, if you look at Enterprise, they have the whole third season of Enterprise. They go to the, I think it's the Anisian Expanse. I think that's the name of it. It's some sort of expanse, and it's a nebula. You got to be very, very careful flying your ship through it. So yeah, it does make sense that there is kind of like this nebula here that divides the alphas and the gamma quadrants. So that's why the wormhole at Bajor is so valuable in Deep Space Nine, because it's hard to get up here. Anyway, let's take a look at our planet. It's Cardassia Prime. Should be looking good. Yep. OSEC 2, looking good again. Bij 2 looking good. Again, we're probably going to be taking a look at some planets to send off into sectors. We are at 10 out of 10 planets right now. And of course, we are playing with the Alpha mod enabled. So there are some of these blocker tiles that I do, in fact, want to keep. Like this one, look, mineral output plus 2. I mean, why would I want to get rid of that? Aleshma Prime, I believe we got... No, we didn't get rid of one of the Leshma Primes. I thought we did. Spoonhead Prime, same thing. They're pretty much filled up. So the different Cardassias. Ooh, there's the Klingons and the Tellarites are now rivals. Interesting. And we do have some Cardassians coming into this particular spot on planet. So we're doing pretty good for minerals. Not so great for energy right now. We could use a little boost in, I mean, more science is never a bad thing. So let's build ourselves a engineering lab right here. So yes, that's going to suppress that tile. Now, this gives a boost to society research. So we are, in fact, using this. Okay, so I can leave that tile there. It's no big deal. And we are getting the boost from this tile and this tile. So I like the Alpha mod. It makes you play more strategically in terms of what you do on planets. Okay, so that planet's fine. Matar is looking good. Crash is, well, we can upgrade our energy plant there. Themoria, we have some guys coming in there. We're at 2 food right now, so that's good. Well, we can get extra energy, huh? Can we build a geothermal plant? We can. That's going to give us engineering output too, so there's no reason not to build one there. Unessa Prime. How's food here? We're at 3 food right now. Again, if we build an energy-producing building next to a volcano, it's going to get have an extra energy credit. I think it's actually worth clearing this jungle tile and dropping an energy credit, a geothermal plant right there, because we're going to get an extra energy credit from here and here. And you know, I think that will be good for us. But for now, I think we're going to society research. I think we're going to clear this tile as well. We'll just drop down a plain old run-of-the-mill mine on Unessa Prime. Cardassia Quatris. That's right, we have 4 planets in the Cardassia system. Looks like a lot of people packed up and left. Can't say I blame them. There are a lot of blocker tiles. So there's society research bonuses there. That building will be taking advantage of that. That building is taking advantage of that society bonus. And this building is not taking advantage of the society bonus. So we can actually clear this tile. And we can't do that because we are out of energy credits. So that's something that we're going to have to take a look at. Of course, since our fleets are kind of out fighting a war right now, we will be facing a bit of an energy deficit. What's on the go with our fleets anyway? We do have a transport fleet moving up, I believe. They're going to do the invasion, or they have done the invasion already. I can't remember. I think they did the invasion. Yes, okay. And the rest of the transport fleets should be following my main battle fleet here. Good. Okay, so we need to take the third order, and we will drop them where? So they have allies up here. Let's go to Wadi. Let's go to this system first. Okay. So that will get them busy. Construction ships, just going to take a quick look to make sure that there's nothing we're missing in terms of what we can build on the outskirts of our system. How does everyone feel about us right now? I'd say there's a lot of people who really, really don't like us. Shellyaks like us, Tholians, the Breen, and the Bajorans. Bajorans may, in fact, like us at some point. They don't like our slavery policy, that's for sure. They have trust of 92, and they love aliens, though, but they don't like us because we hate anyone different than the superior Cardassians. We are the ultimate spoonheads. United Federation of Planets really doesn't like us. Yeah, so that may again turn out in not our favor. Remember, a little bit earlier in the game, United Federation Planets, the Romulans, and who else was it? I don't know. We had a big invasion here. We lost the Temerians, and things were cool for a while, but we did manage to retake Bajor, which was kind of the big feather in our cap. You know, as long as the Cardassians have Bajor, we have that kind of canon historical event type thing on the go, so I'm happy that we're doing that. So our fleet is moving up, and I do want to take a look at our worlds here. We can't install a governor, can we? I think we're build up on leaders. So we only have 10 out of 10. I really, really need to get to work on kind of government upgrades. So that building, yeah, they're coming in slow there. Cardassian Quatris. Okay, so we still want to clear this tile. Still can't afford it because it costs 100 energy. Okay, we've encountered a hostile fleet in this system. In this system, good. Okay, well, it's not good. I mean, it's good that I know what I'm facing. So they have an invasion fleet up here. Pottle's Pantry. It's quite the name for a planet. Is it called a pantry because they keep all their like biscuits and jams and stuff there? That's what you usually keep in a pantry, isn't it? It's kind of perishable food or non-perishable food. You know, the stuff my grandmother used to keep in the pantry. It was like cans of peaches, stuff like that. Okay, anyway. We'll take out whatever's in this planet. Looks like these guys are at war with someone else, the Turogians. Yeah, these guys are fighting. So that may actually work out in our favor. We do have a substance abuser. I guess they're drinking too much. What's the Cardassian drink again? I think it's Kanar. That's unfortunate for her, so she's into the canard. We have a negative energy balance. That is terrible because that means our shields won't work. But it doesn't look like. I don't think we have shields anyway. I think we somehow managed to get to this point in the game without any shield technology, which is kind of interesting. We're all armor. We're polarizing the hull plating, and we're heading into battle, so. Let's give aid to these guys. We'll take out this hostile fleet. Dim Gigor, Jigor, that's quite the name. Waz Yakono and Dorita. As long as it's not the Corvette Doritos, because I'd have to snack on it. No, this episode is not brought to you by Doritos. I wish it was brought to you by Doritos, because I could go for some sort of chips right now. So let's take out the mining ships. So the construction ship still doesn't have anything to do. Peace offer between Wadi and the Turogians. crap, they made peace. That kind of sucks. Because if they were at war, they would have been distracted, and that would have made my war a lot easier. Okay, there's a spatial rift. Detect it. Should be taken out of this mining station. So that should be done fairly soon. Looks like Pottle's Pantry doesn't have a spaceport, which is awesome. That makes things a lot easier because spaceports can really, really mess you up. You know, it's like Deep Space Nine. Deep Space Nine was able to defend itself for the most part. Did need some fleet help from time to time, but, you know, it's had like so many quantum torpedoes and stuff like that. Imagine they went from photon to quantum torpedoes. What does that even mean, a quantum torpedo? Does that mean that it exists outside the realm of normal time? You know, quantum, you know, quantum mechanics. When I think here quantum, I think time. So I'm not sure how a quantum torpedo could work. I'm sure that there's some sort of fan wiki or something like that that explains the entire thing, but I'm just too lazy to look that up right now. Get a little sip of water, and it looks like Pottle's Pantry doesn't have a lot of fortification, which is great for us. So we'll wait till that has fallen, then we'll send in our assault armies. How's research going? I don't think I've taken a look at research. We're 9 months away from discovering cetramine gas, which increases habitability. We have our army upkeep reduction in 2 months, and vertical farms in 11 months. It took us until 222-26 for Cardassians to figure out how to build upwards. Yeah, we're not great at skyscraper technology. Who'd have thunk? Okay, so let's drop in some Cardassian Marines. Should only need this group. I think there's only 19 or something there. And, okay, 1.2 to 2.4, and we have 2.7 to 4.14. I think we're going to be okay with our assault, but we'll watch it just to make sure. You know, you never know. They could come up with a rebellion again. I've seen that happen before, especially with the Trill. Cardassian Secondus has finished its construction queue. And we do have research complete. Army upkeep minus 10. Excellent. Well, that will make things a little bit cheaper for us. We could have mandatory military service, naval capacity plus 20%, station bar, or hive directive node. I think the naval capacity is something we really need right now because we are way, way over our naval capacity. In fact, it's costing us 59% of our maintenance, or an extra 59% of our maintenance. So even though we're still in the positive, that number could be a lot better for us. Speaking of which, let's take a look at this planet, make sure we got a spaceport on the go, and we'll make sure that it is fully upgraded. We also want to make sure we have a solar panel network. What about this place? Spaceport 4, okay, so they should be good. I think the rest of our planet should be good for spaceports, and we do have the solar panels up. Excellent. So we have taken this planet. Yes, the Cardassians are in charge. We're at 26% now for war score. Third order, well, let's go to Wadi Space. Are they the Wadi? I don't think I've heard of the Wadi before. I've heard of the Dominion. And who else is in the Gamma Quadrant? Chimera? The Dosi? The Tarogians? Ooh, there is a fairly large fleet back here. Well, not a large fleet, just a single ship. Never mind. They're probably bombarding this planet, though, right? Yeah, that will take them a while to actually bombard. I think we're going to be okay by moving on to a new planet. And we do have an experimental fleet in OSEC for some reason with Elim Russo. Where did they come from? I should get them to join up with the First Order. Yeah, you join up with you. Good. You don't have the fleet logistician perk, do you? No. That's too bad. That would have made things cheaper on me. But oh well. I am holding the First Order back just in case the United Federation of Planets decides to get, self-righteous and tries to liberate the rest of known space. Third Order, they're still moving to the Wadi system. Okay, how's the rest of research going? 6 months for that, 20 months for that. in 8 months for that. Let's take a look at our planets again. We are really, really hurting for energy credits right now. So I'm going to see if I can actually conduct a trade. Let's take a look at our friends. And Shellyak. Okay. No, don't declare war. Calm down, Durinde. Calm down. We want to trade. We don't want to declare war, so we want an instant transfer. Okay, obviously they don't have that many energy credits. So we will do this trade and control, and we'll get one. Okay, who else can we trade with? I mean, we're doing 400 minerals a month, so yeah, I think it will be a good idea to continue trade. So let's try the Tholians. The Bajorans like us now. Trade deal. They don't have any energy at all. Okay. That's too bad. Who else do we have here? The Breen? The Breen should have energy. They're kind of robotic dudes. No. Okay, never mind. What about the Cardassians? Not the Cardassians, the Bajorans. Oh my god, how far has the Cardassians fallen if they're trading with the Bajorans? Communicate, offer a trade deal. They don't have any energy to trade either. My god, what's on the go here? Okay, who else do we have? We have a couple fragmented nations. The Dominion? Okay, let's see if we can trade with the Odos. Trade deal. Of course, we won't get a good exchange on this instant transfer, but credits is credits, yo. So let's see if we can get 2,000 and minerals, instant transfer, and we'll pump this up. Again, we'll have to. That's the best you're gonna do, minus 22. Okay, so we'll have to pump this down. Can you pump something down? I suppose you could. Equivalent to sucking the air out of it, I guess. Not really a pumping action, though, would it be? Yeah, you could pump the air out of something. I'm giving this way too much thought. Well, we're up to 975 energy credits anyway. So that's the most important thing. So we should be able to build some things now. So, okay, this planet's doing good. Cardassian Quatris, they're clearing that. Their deal is that they don't have any population. Inessa's waiting for population to come in. Themoria, same deal. Crash, Matar. Wait, did I see an upgrade on Crash? No, I didn't. Matar's looking good. We are taking advantage of the minerals here. Are we taking advantage of the energy from here? Yes, we are. And are we taking advantage of the engineering research in this tile? We're not. So we may as well clear that tile. We do have to keep an eye out for stuff like that. Mineral output plus one, and mineral output plus one again. You know, it's worth it for me to actually clear this tile, because by itself it produces two minerals. So, I mean, yes, we'll lose one mineral from here, but, I mean, we'll be able to develop this tile as mine, which will work out much better for us in the future, I believe. We can upgrade this. And, okay, you're doing mineral output plus one. You're doing energy credits plus one. And we are taking advantage of the energy credits. We have run into an enemy fleet. Inessa? No. Wrong button. Okay, in this system. Wow, there is a lot in the Wadi system. It's like they're all wadded up in one space. A big old wad of Wadi. That's my plural for the Wadi, a wad. I don't know if that's the correct plural. I don't know if that's their preferred plural, but that's what I'm going with. Wad of Wadi. Who are the Wadi anyway? Like I said, aside from the Dominion, I don't really recall that many races in the Gamma Quadrant. They're fanatic traders. They're diplomatic and they're materialistic. They have four systems. They're at war with us. And, yeah, they're just kind of a standard prosthetic forehead race in the Star Trek universe, you know. It's you can tell the episodes that don't have a great budget, you know. The alien has kind of, you know, three dots on the side of his cheek. That's it. Or the alien has, a larger chin. I don't know if I've seen an alien on Star Trek with a larger chin. And then they have the big budget episodes where, you know, you got the full face prosthetics and, you know, like, it's like the reptile Zindi, you know, they had the budget then to do those guys up. Always found the reptile Zindi, they look a lot like the antagonist, I find, from the Tim Allen classic. What was the name of that film? Had Alan Rickman in it. It was a parody, basically, of Star Trek, and I'm completely blanking on it right now. And anyone who's listening to it knows exactly what I'm talking about. It's like, yo, the name of that film is, and I can't remember, Galaxy Quest! There we go. I actually remembered it. Yeah, Alan Rickman, Tim Allen, Sigourney Weaver. Excellent film. I'm blanking on a lot of stuff this evening. I should have maybe had more vitamin C or something like that, or some sort of fish oil tablets, or I don't know. The guy who plays guitar, Picard. Why can't I remember his name? I'm doing terrible. Oh my. You know, send fish oil tablets to P.O. Box. No, I should know his name. Patrick Stewart. There we go. You got to think of, like, the most English name ever. Another thing I also found odd about Star Trek, you know, Jean-Luc Picard, supposed to be this French guy, but he was, like, the most English of English persons ever. English of English persons. It's the most English guy ever. And do the French drink Earl Grey tea? You know, that's not what they're known for. Is it French Earl Grey tea? French drink wine. Of course, Picard's family did own the winery. I wonder what happened to the winery. Of course, in the First Contact movie, Picard's brother and his nephew and his sister-in-law died in that fire. They did have that winery, so was that left to Picard? You know? Can Picard retire to that now? I'm thinking yes. I'm thinking that's where he would end up after he retired from Starfleet, if he ever did, in fact, retire from Starfleet. You never know. They may pull a Generations for Star Trek The Next Generation and bring him, like, into some sort of movie 20 years down the road where he dies, like he's stuck in a time loop and he dies defending the galaxy like Captain Kirk did. It's quite a way for Kirk to go. Okay. I still have to watch the Undiscovered Country. I mentioned this a few videos back, I think, that I did see it was the 25th anniversary of Undiscovered Country, and I haven't seen it since it came out. I do remember watching the Undiscovered Country. I didn't watch it in the theater because I lived in basically the boondocks of Canada, rural Canada. But I did remember renting the video and seeing that. And I don't remember watching it since. So that's on my to-watch list. I don't think it's on Netflix either. Netflix in Canada has an odd selection of movies. Like, they have the first two Next Generation movies. They have First Contact and Generations, and then that's it. Can unlock battleships, water treatment plants, mineral processing plants, which increases minerals by 10% on the planet. I think we're going to have to go for that. And what did we just finish? Vertical farms. Can we upgrade any of our current farms to vertical farms? I guess we can upgrade our biodomes or the greenhouse complex. So we'll do that. Clear that. So we're going from producing farms and orb-like buildings to skyscrapers. And it took us till 2227 to figure out that we have to build upwards. Spoonhead Prime. Okay, we can upgrade you. Cardassius second this. Nothing there to do. Tetrius. We do have a guy coming in here. Food's at 11. Plenty of food, actually. We are tapping into the input here. Now, is it worth keeping this mountain range? Yes, we do get an extra mineral here, but I could pump a mine here or drop a mine here, and we would get extra mineral output. I think it's worth it to clear this tile. So what are we going to build here, though? Mineral output +1, so I think we're going to drop down a mine. Unless there's something better here, I could do a natural fuel sorcerer that produces energy and minerals. It already produces two minerals. Now let's go for a natural fuel sorcerer. We do use natural fuels. Matar Prime. So you produce energy. So this is just a standard power plant. We should have a geothermal plant here. Yeah. It's gonna work out better for us, I think, in the long run. Matar Prime, it never hurts to go through your planets, even if you've built buildings and say, hey, are we doing the best that we can here? Energy credits +1. Same thing, we have a power plant here, we should replace it. Okay, no, that's the exact same planet I was looking at before. We do want a physics building here, a physics lab, a crash prime. I think we're okay here. The Moria Prime. Okay, for now. Yanessa almost has population coming in. Cardassian Quatris. It would be great if we had some more people. Do we have like a food crisis here or something? No, it's just people don't want to live there. And Asmor Prime again. We're waiting for that initial kind of settlement phase to finish up. Doing 14 energy a month, which is a lot better than before, but still not great. How come we're not bombarding Wadi 3? You guys just decided to stick around in orbit and not do anything? Show some initiative. You have an admiral. Who's your admiral now? Ileana Nador. Ileana, I expect better of you. Victory against the Earth. Okay, we won. Our assumptions about the Cardassian weakness may have been hasty. So come our new experience, we accept your demands to the best possible outcome. I don't even remember what my demands are. So we have made them a tributary. We've humiliated them. That's the, not them. These folk. Yeah. So good job on the Gamma Quadrant, guys. I'm impressed. I'm really impressed that we managed to pull that off. Third Order, you guys got to go home. Well, not home. You got to go to a friendly system anyway and get repaired. And that's going to put our energy credits back into the positive a little bit more. Now that that war has been taken care of, I think we're almost due for attacking the Ferengi again. Are they still part of the, what was it, Sanguine League? They're still inferior to us. Trill should be pathetic. They're unfriendly. Yeah, we should be able to take them out. Fleet power is inferior. Naval capacity is pathetic. And their technology is equivalent. They do have quite a few planets, though, settled. So it will take us a little while to actually take them over. It might take a bit of doing, actually. So we do have the Fourth Order ready to go down here, or the First Order, rather. The Bajorans are with us. And do we have anyone that we can integrate? We've had the Tholians and the Sheliak for quite a while, actually. So let's take a look at the Tholians. Tholian Assembly, let's communicate with them. Can we demand vassalization? They're loyal, but they don't like the population. Why? Because we have less or more people. We can guarantee their independence. So no, that's a no to the Tholians. What about the Sheliak? Sheliak under the S. Elemental PQRS. Sheliak corporate communicates. Oh, we can demand vassalization from them. Now, the question is, will this reduce our income? Because we should be taking in 25% of whatever they produce. I haven't tried this before, so this is going to be a new thing for me. Demand vassalization. Confirm. Yeah, let's see what they say about that. We're at 24, so we're at minus 10. So yes, we did indeed lose credits by making those guys a vassal. But on the upside of things, that means that if we go to war, they will now follow us into war. What about the Bajorans? They're a tributary, right? Yes. Just want to check. They haven't been under our thumb long enough, I don't think. Bajoran Republic, let's communicate. We could offer them protectorate status. So they pay 8%. So, okay, if they become a protectorate, their technology will increase, they'll become an ally, basically, and then they'll eventually become a vassal. Let's offer them protectorate status. Changing things up a little bit. Not how I normally do things, but, you know, you gotta take risks sometime. Yes, logic dictates, yeah, whatever your Kai says. We know what's going to happen. Gul Dukat is going to end up boning your Kai. That's how it works out. Okay, so Third Order getting repaired. I feel like I should actually bring these guys back. They are so far out of the way. We do have a few transport fleets that are like way, way out there. Let's bring them back to Bij, I guess. I mean, we only took on the Gamma Quadrant because I needed something to do. I couldn't attack the Ferengi, who were my next kind of target. So, yeah. All right, so the Bajorans are now a protectorate. So that means if we go to war, well, we'll have their massive fleet of, like, two ships helping us out. What about the Tholians? They do have a transport fleet. They do have a first fleet. Neat. It's going to help us out. Keyed system has been surveyed. Speaking of which, let's take a look at our expansion planner. Is there anywhere that is worth colonizing for us? 50% for everything. We're really hurting for energy right now. We do have this planet. Has quite a bit of energy, not so much food. So where is this? It's in Tholian space? Oh, it's over here. Well, let's go for it. Nothing to lose. So let's get the plant submarine, colonize, and we'll drop in some loyal Cardassians into, oh, there's a Batharian stone there, which makes things even better. Actually, I don't want to build there because I do want to build a geothermal plant there. Let's stick you guys here. Okay, so we're doing a bit of expansion, excellent. And of course we already have Themoria settled, so that's why it's a little bit cheaper for us to settle there. Let's take a look at our planetary surfaces again. Man, we're really hurting though for leadership technology. I could do so much more if I had more leaders. I don't have any free governors right now, do I? No, we do have a free scientist for some reason. Why do we have a free scientist? Technology. Science ship? Ship's working. Construction ship. We should send our construction ship here. Because once we've colonized that system, that means we're going to have access to whatever is in this system. And our science ship, we should scan this system. Because we may indeed have access to whatever is in that system. Also want to scan. Oh, that belongs to the Sheliaks. Can scan. Oh, it lies within Cardassian Union space. We should definitely have a look at this then. This system as well. Research is done. What's that? We can add a medium deflector to our ships. Shields! Shields might be really, really good. Energy capacity plus 1,000. That's not really going to help us right now. Migration speed 25%. Let's go for shields for our ships. What did we just finish? We finished deflectors. So we're going to have to take a look at our ship designer. Corvettes. I don't really want to change out the Actually, we do have a ton of power, so I don't mind changing out the backup system there. Save that, yeah. I mean, this deflector, what does it do? Increases armor by 8%. Sounds good to me. Destroyer, we do have an empty slot here, so we'll drop one of those in. What about our cruisers? Lots of slots there. Deflector. I mean, I could see this game becoming like really strategic and tactical once you get kind of all of your technologies researched, because, well, I mean, how much damage does this do? Medium, okay, yeah, no, we can't put a small thing in there. Because you do have a lot of slots to work with, right? Combat sensors tracking. Sensor range 1. No, we don't want to change the set. Just double checking everything here. Okay, we'll save that. And we're going to want to upgrade our fleets. First order. So it's at 4052. Hopefully this will bring that number up. And of course we still don't have any shields. We are burning through energy again. Well, who can we talk with? Who had energy last time? Was it Shellac? Communicate? Trade deal? Energy credits? What do you have for us? Oh, you run up to 50 pretty quick. We're going to trade you minerals, instant transfer. It's 2 and 1. And get rid of this. Confirm. Apparently you can't trade energy credits for energy credits. I don't know why. Trade deal offered. Excellent. Who are these guys? Knight Federation Plans? You're all the way over there? Not fun. Federation's not at war with anyone, are they? I can't kind of sneak in and get them while they're fighting someone else. They're fighting the Klingon right now. They have a war score of 3. And the Klingons are fighting the Romulan and the Nausicaans? Okay. I guess the Nausicaans are part of a coalition, or the Romulans are. Okay, no, we don't want to talk to the Romulans. Speed things up again. We're losing 25 credits a month. That's not good. Of course, we do have that colonization effort underway. And we are upgrading a couple buildings, so once that's done, we should be in a little bit better position. Okay, I'm not sure if that number went up at all or if it went down. I think it might have went down, actually. First order. I don't know. Anyway, let's take a look at our surfaces. And I have to sneeze, so I have my nose scrunched up so much right now. It's not even funny. Mineral output plus 1. Well, it's not minerals that we're worried about. It is energy. Let's clear this tile. And let's drop in... Probably not going to use the society research either. Build a natural fuels converter. Can we build a nuke plant? Weapons factory, pressure dock. I guess we're going for natural fuels converter. Okay, Inessa. Okay, that's the planet we just looked at. Themoria. Crash. Pretty much maxed out. I mean, again, is this a Batharian reactor? Batharian stones? Planetary capital. We have a Batharian stone there? Is that a waste? Seems like it's a waste to me. Okay, so, if I clear this tile and I build a mine here, I'm probably going to be producing more than 3 minerals. So I'm going to clear this tile. Got to think strategically now, because... planets are starting to become more and more precious as things in the galaxy get researched and colonized. Where's our science ship? Science ship's got to go all the way around there to do some scanning. Okay. Whatever. Where's the third order? Third order's going to have to take a while to get home because they do have to go through that expanse. Now, capacity is up. That's good. That's going to make things a little bit cheaper for us. We could build a university. So it's 22-28, and we're only now unlocking a technology that you'd get in like turn 250 in civilization. Research alternative, security agency, or colony development speed. Security agency view. Xenophobia minus 10. Planet toughness plus 10%. University society plus 10. Let's go for research alternatives. How's the rest of research going? 13 months, 31 and 20. And what did we just finish? Let's finish naval capacity. So we are at 30% as opposed to 51%. We're actually back into the positive now for energy credits. And we do have our fleets kind of moving back through the expanse here. So once they get home, we should be in pretty good position again. Okay. I think maybe let's see about taking on the Ferengi. I could try to take on Trill, but they're kind of their own special independent things. I don't know how that's going to work out for us. Can we talk to them? We don't want to join their coalition. Okay, the Ferengi. Road of acquisition, yes. Okay, is war good for business? Sure, why not? We want to declare war. And what do we want? We want to humiliate them. Station. Do we want them to cede planets? Probably not. What else can we do? We can't vassalize them. It's too expensive. I'd have to take off humiliate, but I could make them a tributary. I guess that's kind of our only option. And after they're a tributary for a while, we could then vassalize them. Okay. Anyone want to help us? Answer to that is an emphatic no. The opponents are the Ferengi and the Trill. We're going to confirm that war. Okay, so let's grab the First Order. Let's go take out whatever is in Trill space. Of course, we do have to remember, we can't take Trill. We've tried it before. They have rebellions over and over again and again. So the only thing to do is basically leave a fleet in orbit so we can grab the war score for the blockade. So that's what we're going to do. Third Order, how many jumps are you away now? You're still quite a ways away. So, okay, that's fine. Energy credits still not looking great. The Bajorans, you don't like us again. It's a relative power. Can we trade energy credits? Instant transfer? No, you're not going to trade us. Yes, your logic dictates you're worse than a Vulcan, Bajorans. What about the Breen? Let's try the Breen again. Trade deal. Energy credits. Instant transfer. No, that's not going to work for us. What about the Odos? Okay, we'll try the Gorn first. Trade deal. Energy credits. Instant transfer. Okay, everything's going to minus 50 automatically, so I don't know if that's a bug or a feature or what. I did have a trade issue in another game where I couldn't get the trade numbers to go up, so I don't know. So yeah, we now have Sheliak helping us out because they are a vassal of ours. I thought the Bajorans were a vassal. No, they're a protectorate. Yeah, they won't join the war until they become a vassal. A construction ship has nothing to do, and they won't have anything to do until we actually settle that world. Okay, our colony ship is still being constructed. Good to know. Alright, I guess we're not going to be doing any trading for energy credits, at least not for a while. Hopefully this war doesn't go on too long. What are you? You're the Sheliak. You're going to help us out with our war. Excellent. It's nice to finally have some allies. We have been standing alone against the weaker races of the universe. Of course, the Cardassians are the best thing since sliced bread. Okay. Oh, sec. Take a look at our planetary surfaces while we're waiting for our fleets to get in place. In Nessa, Moria. Oh, we do have someone going into this tile. And this is a mineral producing tile, or it should be. We need energy more than anything else, though. So, do we have any energy-producing buildings? We could have a basic fuels refinery, a mech bay, a moisture farm, natural fuels converter, power hub. What's this do? Energy credits plus 10%. How many energy credits do we produce on this planet? 12. That's not a hell of a lot. 10% of 12 is basically 1.2, which isn't terrific. Do a natural fuels converter, basic power plant. A solar power plant produces 5. Let's go for that. Plus, it's environmentally friendly. And that's what the Cardassians are all about, aren't they? They're environmentally friendly. Sure they are. You didn't see that episode of Deep Space Nine where Gul the Cat set up a solar panel network on Bajor? That's season 6, episode 23. No, it's not. Please don't try to look that up because I am lying and I am lying through my teeth. Never really got that turn of phrase, lying through your teeth. I mean, do you grit your teeth while you're lying? I don't. I just kind of lie. I just open my mouth and lie away. So, fleet. Where? Transport fleet. Ooh, who are these guys? Privateers. Well, that's not good. Can you guys jump out? Retreat in 28 days. Okay, so we may indeed lose our transport fleet here. 22 days, 21 days, or we'll lose part of our transport fleet. And we are maxed out for minerals right now. Let's try trading again. Okay. Let's try the Dominion trade deal. Okay, let's try offering our minerals first. See if that's helps us out. And energy credits, instant transfer. Puts us at 0. No. Nobody likes us. I think I tried to do the trade anyway. It's not going to work out for us. 8 days, 7 days, 6 days, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Retreat. Okay, get the hell out of Dodge. Okay, and our main fleet's still moving down through the expanse. Where is the First Order? First Order is in orbit around Trill. Must be very trilling for them. We'll take out their spaceport. Peace between the Nausicaans and the Klingons. Okay. So that war is over. So much for taking advantage of that. Well, let's take out their spaceports. Probably going to break my fleet in half. Well, maybe not in half. Maybe I'll make a new fleet. And we'll leave some people in orbit around Trillius Prime. Again, we'll get points for having the planet blockaded, even if we don't take it through sheer force. I just want to make sure that we do have some transport fleets ready to go. Cardassia Prime. Let's build some more assault armies. Gather these specimens. Alien specimen procurement chain. I'm surprised we haven't seen that already. You usually see that very early in Stellaris games. Right, so let's take out there, whatever this is, space station. And it really sucks that I can't trade right now. And I don't know why that is. Maybe there's actually an upper limit on how many times you can trade. Might keep people from getting too powerful. Power overwhelming. Did our colony ship. Yep, the colony ship was built. Excellent. So once that planet's colonized, that should help with our energy crisis as well. And also, if we do lose a couple of ships, that may not be so bad at this point. Okay, the spaceport's never really had a chance. A Trillius Prime. Okay, we're gonna create a new fleet, and we're gonna have. Sure, let's have a cruiser and a destroyer. Let's have two destroyers. We don't need a huge fleet. We just need you to stay in orbit. Okay. This fleet, we will head to Pabma. We will take out whatever it is in Pabma. We're at 40% for war score already, which is pretty balling. I think we need like 90% though. They may in fact capitulate before that happens. Oh, looks like our allies have engaged the Ferengi. How's that war going? 1.3, and they are probably going to lose. Okay, first order is in orbit around Trill. Let's see if we can actually catch up to these guys. I don't know if this is going to work out, though, because they are probably a couple jumps away, so they may not make it in time to help out our Sheliak allies. But I would like to catch that fleet if I can. First order. Moving to the Eulis system. Okay. So where are they actually in the system? Yeah, they have to move to the outskirts before anything else happens. That's why it helps to invest in thruster technology. Got to get the old impulse drives going. How long will it take them to jump? 2 days to that sector, and then whatever the transit time is. How's the fight going here? Hopefully our friends can hold out long enough. I'm not sure that's going to happen, though. They have 4 ships to their 38. Research is done. We could actually have shields now. Good lord. Multiphasic shields, regenerative shields, and whatever this word is, shields. What's the difference? Shield hit point 7200. Shield regeneration 14.4. Shield hit points 14.4 and plus 25%. Okay, so that's more expensive. And shield hit points plus 20%. So these regenerate faster. I think I'm going to go for that. And we will take a look at our ship designer. And let's take a look at adding some shields. What's that going to take? Okay, where do I add shields? Is it any of these slots? What's this? Scout? No, we don't want scouts. Shields? Maybe that technology just gives you the ability to research shields? Researched shields. Shields, heavy escort. No, there should be something that we can add to our ships. Maybe corvettes are out of the question. Nuclear reactor, nuclear fusion. Oh, shields. Okay, so we could have polarized hull plating or shields. Okay, so that's extra armor. And that's the shields. Okay, let's go for that. All points, all the armor goes down, but we now have shields, right? Yeah. Go for shields. Because that's kind of the order of things, you know. The Federation goes from polarized hull plating to shields. I didn't save the design of my destroyers, so I'm going to have to do that. Save, Telok. Cruiser is ready. Battle cruiser. I'm going to go for shields there as well. Save. Yes. Okay. They're down to 700. Where's the First Order now? They're in FTL. And it looks like our allies have jumped out. Okay. But we still might make it to that system. First Order. Are they going to jump out soon? Warping to Eurus. Okay. Still not quite there yet. New contact with the Talaxians. Interesting. Talaxians! Oh, it's Neelix! Talaxian Empire. So we're now dealing with the Delta Quadrant. Keep out of the way or we'll make you. Shouldn't they be like over here? I'm assuming this would be the Delta Quadrant. Talaxians. They closed their borders. Yeah, I was right. I didn't think the Talaxians had an empire. I don't remember seeing any other Talaxians aside from Neelix in Voyager. And that's something that I haven't seen in a long time either. Voyager, I've seen... Okay, they do have a 400-strength fleet coming down here. We have a 300-strength fleet. This may not go well for us. Station complete. Automatic defense procedures initiated. Okay, they have one ship there, 43. Governor has leveled up. And our science ship... should be warping down, warping out. Yeah, okay. These guys are leaving. Oh, they're gonna fight us. Okay. First Order, where are we now? First Order. First Order, where are you? Okay, they're jumping to this system, so I don't know if there's actually anyone here right now. Is there anybody out there? Call if you can hear me. Okay, a little bit of comfortably numb for you. Nope, nobody in the system. Darn it, I was kind of hoping we would catch up to this fleet. We still might catch up to them because they are actually more powerful than us right now. Seems like it might be a good idea for us to head home and upgrade if we can before we do anything else. And since they are more powerful than us, might be a good idea to spend some of these credits. Just saying.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Where? So if we engage Second Order. Okay, so our 300 strength fleet versus their 43 strength fleet. Hopefully our cruisers should win. I have faith. Bring out the phasers, you mighty Cardassians. Playing a little bit of Ring Around the Rosie here. Accuracy at 85%. We are firing some explosive damage, doing damage to armor. And they should die very soon. There we go. And you guys need to attack their assault craft. Of course, our war score is back at zero right now. That's because we're not blockading Trill. Are these Trill? So, like, where are these ships coming from? Because as far as I know, Trill only has, like, the one planet, Trillius Prime. Do they have a secret Trill base? Were they attacking someone else? Man, these assault craft are... can be tough sometimes. Okay, they warped out. Good. Alright, back to Trillius, back to the bombardment. Back to life, back to reality. Transport Fleet 19, where are you? You are in Sinestra, which is a long way away. See if you can get down to Themoria. I think that's the group that were fighting the pirates, and then they retreated. Science ship not doing anything. Send you on a mission of exploration. Have we checked out these systems? I don't think we have. I think they warped in somewhere and then they didn't do anything. Survey system. So, is that planet now actually colonized? Yes. We are taking advantage of the 4 energy here. I guess we are. Our construction ship build stuff automatically? I don't remember sending them to do anything, but I guess they did. Go me, anyway. So where's the First Order now? First Order is... where? Okay, yeah, they're heading back for the upgrades. Where's the Third Order? Third Order? Be fairly close to home now. That's not the Third Order. No, they're not in the middle of the galaxy. Okay, Third Order. Let's see if we can actually take this system. I mean, I could have a massive fleet if I joined up the First and Third Order. Strength of about 4,500. Hostile fleet where? Ferengi Alliance. That system, 298. It's nothing super bad or terrible that we shouldn't be able to take out. Third Order. Okay, so let's see if we can take it Tal 3. And we do have mineral processing plants now. Could upgrade the mech lances. Of course, mech's not really Star Trek lore, so we'll ignore that for now. Industrial fabricator, Corvette assembly yards, defense plants platform. Let's go for the Corvette assembly yards. Being able to pump out Corvettes might be a good thing for us. What just exploded? They blew up their spaceport for some reason. Hostile fleets. Okay, a couple of Rengi. 2.5k. What system is that? That Trill? No, that's in Neef. Actually, you know what? We'll send the third order home to get healed up as well. The guys holding Trill, they may die. Sorry to say. If you were rooting for that particular fleet, things may not work out for them. So, the first order, Inessa, so they are getting upgraded. Third order, okay. Okay, the smart move would have been to go to Trill and to take out my fleet that was there, but they seem to be falling back right now. Ships have been upgraded for the first order. That puts us up to 26. We don't need to heal now. So, how big was that Ferengi fleet? We do have... That's the thing, we have shields now, but we don't have any energy credits. Can I get away with doing a trade? Or will they still not like it for whatever reason? Energy credits, instant transfer, automatically minus 50. Let's just try someone else. But I suspect that this isn't going to work. Credits, instant transfer. This one may work, except they don't have a lot of energy credits to trade. Minerals. Firm. Being back in the positive for a little bit will be nice anyway. Trade deal has been accepted. Excellent. Good. Okay. So the second order is still doing its bombardment. Again, we won't invade Trill. And that's because they always seem to generate a rebellion. Alright, so, I think I'm going to wrap things up there. So what did we do? We finished off the war with these folks, the Agartharians. Then we went to war with the Ferengi. We've upgraded a few planets. And hopefully next episode, we will make the Ferengi a tributary, which should work out well for those because they're noted traders and they should bring us a nice few energy credits and stuff like that. So wrapping things up there, if you enjoyed the episode, please think about liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Hopefully see you next time. Have a great day.